These are the top 5 features you must know about in the latest Power BI update of September 2019. These top 5 features will make your reports look good, give you more control. Hey, who doesn't want that, right? When working with Power BI files, it's going to make it easier for you to work in Power BI Desktop. And not just that, there's a feature which is going to make it easier for your users to use your Power BI reports. And last but not least, it's going to make you look more handsome and get you a pay raise. Well, actually, the last one, maybe only half true. Our number one feature this time is something small, but we feel has a big impact. So stick around for that. Let's start at number 5, but let me also point you to some useful resources. If you want to catch up on all the recent Power BI updates, just click in the corner and access our complete month-by-month playlist. And if you're just getting started or keep getting stuck in Power BI, make sure to check out our complete step-by-step Power BI tutorial. I'm Avi Singh, Microsoft MVP and best-selling Power BI author. And if you want to become a Power BI pro, make sure to subscribe and click that bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. Number 5 on our list today is new Power BI themes. You can access the themes feature by going to the Home tab and it's right there, switch theme. Now, Power BI team has done some work to create new themes which are supposedly brighter, better, bolder. So you're gonna find that in here. And any new file you create will use this new default theme. Now, of course, the old files will keep the classic theme, which if you're still fond of, then you can access it under more themes. And even if new report you wanted to have the classic old look, you can go back and select that. And I'll say it comes down to personal preference, but I do prefer the classic look. It's a little muted, and if you've heard me talk about visualization, I'm a Stephen Few fan, and it talks about kind of a gentler, milder approach, right, when you don't hit the people on the head with data with flashy visualization. So I kind of like the classic look, so I may stick with that. But you know, I'll just show you, you can switch to the default theme and it might mess up your reports a little bit, so watch out for that. So if you go back and update your reports to this new theme, then you might have to go fix something. So let me just show you the the colors that'll show. So here I just put kind of on the legend so you can see the colors. And of course, if you go check out the color palette over here, you're gonna see that how it looks quite different than the regular palette. There are some other usability improvements as well, such as font sizes and things like that, which also would make the default new theme probably more usable. Number 4 are some improvements to the visualization pane. The good old visualization pane, so it's got some updates. So this is the feature that I'm talking about. This is the visualization pane, and it's been the same way for a while now. Now, the improvement for this update is that if you can kind of customize it. So if there are some visuals which you don't use, perhaps you don't tend to use the R visual, you can unpin that visual. And it's going to ask you, say, okay. Maybe you don't use Python either, or something like that. So you get the idea here that you can kind of customize the look, and you can unpin the visuals you don't use. And that's going to give you a little more control over it. And of course, so these ones are being shown here right now, but if you open a new file, they will completely disappear. They wouldn't be shown. And what you're going to have to do to restore them is to come back here and say restore default visuals. And that's going to put them back on that panel over here. So again, just gives you a little more control. And that's hopefully is going to make you much faster as well building your report. So you can unpin the visuals you never use, and that's going to make it a little more tight and concise and easy to use. Now, of course, one visual which sometimes doesn't get love from everybody is the pie chart. I'll admit that I'm on the fence on this one as well. My mentor, Stephen Few, he seems to be totally against pie charts. So I'm asking you, are you going to unpin the pie chart or not? Leave a comment, let me know. Is that something that you use or do not like to use? Let's move on to number 3, which is more conditional formatting. Now, of course, Power BI team has promised that essentially what they're doing is making every element in the you know, kind of the color and other elements of this, they're making it so that you can customize them, you can program them almost, and they just keep extending it feature after feature. Now, I will say that sometimes it can be a little hard to find, but often you're going to find this when you hover over something and you see these three dots, which well kind of disappear as soon as I click that. But if you look here, if these three dots appear, then I want you to click on that, and that's where you're going to find conditional formatting, and that's going to have a lot of rich options, which we have covered in prior updates, so I'm not going to rehash that. Go watch the previous updates to get the details on how conditional formatting really works. But this specific release, let me just switch to that tab here. It introduces conditional formatting for border. So if you go to your border color and you turn it on, then this now can be conditionally formatted, right? So you can maybe use the border to emphasize that specific visual if certain conditions are met. And also a lot of the gauge chart got a lot of love. So a lot of elements here can be conditionally formatted. So in fact, I think I did play around and added a fill conditional formatting to the fill color, and you can see that now it is based on rules, and based on what the measure is, it turns itself yellow, red, or green, and that's conditional formatting in play for you. Number two is the ability to custom format strings. Now, I'll admit that this was a little hard to find for me. Now, of course, now that I found it, I realized that Power BI team was always pointing me in the right way. So, custom format sounds really cool. Of course, in Excel, think about that, how you can really specify a custom string to format any number or anything else. And so this is similar to that, although it uses VBA style strings. We're going to link to the complete video from the Power BI team so that you can get more details on that. So here, let's try the variance measure, which is right here actually. So if I go to variance, and the first place that I was looking for was format menu, and I really don't quite understand that why the custom option wasn't shown here. Actually, I can imagine, but that's the first place that I was looking for, and of course that's not the right place to look. At least it's not available in that spot. The only spot it is available, the custom formatting, is in the modeling tab, which is accessed by clicking on this button. So if I click on the modeling tab, and now if I click around and click to that measure, then you see that I have a lot of formatting options, and one of those is the new custom format. So let me try that. So I'm going to switch that to a custom format. And here, now I have this option to select from few dropdowns, but I also have the option to kind of type in anything that I want in here. So again, you can see how the format strings pretty similar to Excel as well, right? So you can type in and kind of create and define your own format using these string rules. And of course, now if I go back to the report, then you can see that it is formatted based on my custom formatting. All right, we're on to our number one, the small but big feature. Hey, another shout out to our Power BI tutorial. So if you're just getting started or find yourself keep getting stuck in Power BI, then make sure to check it out. All right, so our number one feature today is drill through discoverability. Now you're gonna see this feature and you're gonna say, Avi, seriously, how's this number one? But I'll tell you why I feel this is number one. So let's go back and see where this feature shows up. And again, it's really subtle. So the Power BI team got some feedback, rightly so, when there is drill through enabled. So drill through, I'll show you what it looks like. So we've covered this. Actually, we'll be covering this in separate videos. Make sure to look out for that. So I can say drill through, and I can say give me country detail, and it takes me to another page. Now the challenge is that sometimes if you're just looking at the report, you don't really know. And frankly, for a lot of cases, sometimes there is drill down available, and sometimes in this case, there is drill through available. And one of those old things, right? If a tree falls in a forest, does it make a sound, right? So if there is something cool that you built into a report, but users can't find it, is it really there, right? So you could have done a lot of work with this report, with drill through or drill down on some of these features, if they're not discoverable, then they're not worth anything. So I think this is a key feature, and I'm really glad that Power BI team is focusing on this. Now, so again, this is subtle. I wish it wasn't so subtle. I wish this was more in the face or something like that, but still, it's something that's better than nothing. So here, when people hover over this, it just gives you a small general reminder that, hey, you can right-click to drill through. Again, I would like to see this for drill down as well, and maybe other scenarios, and maybe have it be more in the face and something, you know, kind of popped up on here or something like that if I hovered over it. Now, of course, there are other tricks where you can add help desk to visuals and so forth to do that, but this is a nice improvement by the Power BI team to see that what they're doing to try to make these things a little more discoverable, which is going to make everyone's life easier. So hey, that was our September 2019 update. If you want to catch up on all the recent Power BI updates, just click in the corner and access our complete month-by-month playlist. Well, let me know what you thought. Do you think that these features do make your reports look good, give you more control, and make it easier for you and your users to work on your Power BI reports? So let me know in the comments down below. And until next time, power on. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.